So this first one is originally by the Flying Burrito Brothers, and it's called Sin City.
Yep.
This whole town is filled with sin. It'll swallow you in. If you got some money to burn, take it home right away. You got 3 years to pay. But Satan is waiting his turn. So
you guys can hear it. Hi, Laura. Hi, Leslie.
Hi, everybody.
All right, what's the next one? Oh, what's done is done. All right.
Okay. This is a little weird, but glad you're all out there.
Can we turn yours up? Your volume, your vocals up a tad.
Yeah.
I'm trying to back away from the mic, but you know. You gotta turn Paul up just a tad, because I can get really loud and let us know if the balance works out.
Yep. Probably guitar down a little bit, get a little more of the real acoustic sound. Okay, right?
Oh, thanks, Jeff.
What do you say?
Awesome harmonies, man.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
We love doing harmonies, it's part of what we do. With Holly and Polly, this duo.
Hi, Leslie. All right, so this next one is, I'm going to let Paul introduce this one.
All right. Yeah, this is a Jack White song. Jack White, obviously a great modern rocker who plays homage to all these great styles. This one's like a country kind of
murder ballad.
Yeah, yeah. He did an album with Loretta Lynn. So he's walked the walk as far as playing some country and you know, so I don't know who the woman that he's singing with on the album, but they had some great harmony, so this one came together naturally. I'm like, oh, let's just do this one. It sounds great. So, okay. What's done is done. If you want to see a great performance, check out Jack White on Saturday Night Live,
oh,
like last year. Oh my gosh. Wow, what a just a power trio can do live. That's an example right there. Just unbelievable. Anyway, big fan.
Lorelai?
Yep.
Can we move?
Yeah, we can move.
This is one we've only done a few times, actually, and it is written by, well, it was a Pogue song originally.
I don't know anyone else who's done it, but...
Yeah, and I think the person who wrote the song has actually passed away.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah, sad. Huh. But, well, you know, he wrote a beautiful song, so this one's called Lorelai. Yeah, Jack White is like... You just, my God. All right, you got it?
Yep. Yeah, so this one has different kind of harmonies. So I was kind of, I felt like, well, let's learn a song that has a different style of harmony for what we're doing here. So it seemed like a natural pick.
Yep.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Told me tales of love and glory. Same old sad song, same old story. Sirens sing no more. fronts. My love, no more I'll see. I thought of you in far off places, puzzled over lipstick traces. So help me God, I will not try. And then I think of Lorelei. I've traveled far and wandered wide. An old photograph of you beside me. Old man rivers not so shy. And he remembers Lorelei. River, river, have mercy. Take me down to the sea. If I should float on this stream and see you in my madman's dream, I'd sink into your troubled eyes, and none would know, say, Lorelei. River, river, have mercy, take me down to the sea. My ship, which sails tomorrow, should crash against these rocks, my sorrows, I will drown before I die. It's you I'll see, the Lorelei.
Such a sad, sad little tale.
So sad.
Crashing into rocks. But none sweeter than a siren song.
I have seen the sea.
All right. So speaking of fairy tales, this is one long ride.
Oh, I think I have the words to this one.
So this is an original. One night I wrote, started writing a song after a gig. I was inspired late night, and I decided I was going to write a train song. So it's modeled after Johnny Cash, same key and everything. However, I did try to make it so that it was a little less obvious as to where the progression goes. Let's take a listener. So hopefully, nope, I don't have it here.
Me neither.
But I'm pretty sure I know the words.
All right, well, Paul knows the words.
Well enough.
He wrote the song.
Yeah.
why, very nice. Oh yeah, Lorelei nice. Is a story about a
sirens, a, right?
Well, it's a woman who was lovesick and threw herself off the cliffs. It's an old Irish tale.
Really?
Yeah. Hmm. Oh, what's going on?
I thought it was, I mean, they mentioned sirens in it, so. I don't know.
Is that Larry? hey. We have some visitors. Hello. Yeah.
We're live.
Yeah, we're live on Facebook right now.
Welcome.
We got some snacks.
Yeah.
We also have my
live for this.
Yeah. Yeah, you gotta be here live for the snacks.
Yeah.
So anyway, we're about to do this song that Paul wrote called One Long Ride.
Yep.
And let's do it.
Okay.
It's a train song.
There's lots more drinks in the red fridge in the garage too, so please help yourself. There's a white wine and yep.
I was gonna say one other thing. There are glasses in the cabinet that is open.
Okay. Right. In here. Okay.
Okay.
This one goes out to all those bicyclists in Flagstaff.
All right.
I got a long ride. Look at me.
It's storming.
Guitar playing. You know what we didn't hear? We didn't hear Shayla or.
It's not on there. That, Did we miss that one? Let's do that one right now.
Oh! All right.
Somehow I missed that one.
We missed one on the list.
Gotta tune up after that. Some bending action. What's going on with that?
I'll do some light playing on this one as well.
We're clapping and hooting here. Hooray!
All right. I'm feeling it. This connection, this live thing, I'm feeling it. Thanks everybody.
The entire pandemic, we avoided
it. It's a leap. Yeah, it's a leap. We've been recording videos, but apparently people like doing Facebook Live, and if that's what they like, then, as a performer, I'm cool with that.
It's way more fun, I'll tell you what.
Than recording to a video and then trying to get it perfect and then post it. Yeah. There's something to be said about that because you can go get it anytime you want, but I guess you can do that with this too. But those are all chopped up into little tasty little bits of songs, so that's kind of fun for the archives. But we've been tracking a lot, so we'll have some like real nice polished mixes of some of our songs pretty soon here. This is one that we've been tracking. Laying down separate guitar tracks, separate vocals, and
I posted this little stuff that this one on my blog because we were just fiddling around with vocal parts, and we need that, right? Yeah. It would be nice to have it. We're still kind of learning it. This is a song from Blondie, and I think. It was written by Chris Stein and one of the other members, and I think it was early mid 70s.
Okay. Keeping in the E theme, here's another one in E.
All right.
Okay. Well, you want to start it off?
Just a number.
All right. That was awesome. Oh, yeah, thanks.
Working girl blues. Love it.
Yeah, I just flipped the chords around them. I'm like, whoa, what am I doing? Thank you. That was fun.
Yeah, love that one.
Little thing popped up on my phone. I gotta
attend to the thing.
Yeah, it's very nerve-wracking.
Things.
There we go.
Need attention. Oh,
sweet, my sister Laura was singing along.
Oh, great. She knows that one?
Yeah. She's the one who turned me on to Blondie.
There you go. I mean, if you're a Blondie fan, of course you know that one.
It was great having a sister 7 years older than me to do that.
Oh, okay.
Well, she's a great musician.
Yeah. And she turned me on to all the prog rock, too.
Yeah.
Oh, Walking After Midnight?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, Randy. We have in the red fridge in the garage there are cold drinks. I don't need the words for this.
No.
I just feel like I do. I get all scared.
Yeah. So this artist, my grandmother turned me on to.
There comes Michael and all those guys too.
Oh, sweet.
These guys are like traveling, workaway volunteers, and they just drove up from Sedona and they want to see you perform.
Okay.
They're just parking the car out front.
Okay.
So give them 5 seconds and they'll probably be in, or just go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, we've got like a bit to go.
You started off with
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to play some guitar. We're trying something new tonight. Paul has this way of being like, oh yeah, do this thing. And then I'm like, all right, I'll try it.
Yeah. So Holly plays harmonica, and she played harmonica in her rock bands in the 90s and stuff. And so she's skilled at it. And so I'm just like, yeah, you want to play harmonica solo? She's like, I'm like, yeah, come on. So here we are.
It's different at 8,000 feet or whatever. Hi. Hi.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome.
Hi.
So I bought a couple bottles, but they just all broke.
Oh, dear. Dear. Oh, bummer.
It's okay, no biggie.
There's a few more folks walked in. Hi!
Hi,
yeah.
Sydney!
Hi! Sorry, we're late.
We're
having a little mishap in the gallery.
I had set up with the animations.
Maybe
just hold it up and turn it on, and then maybe I can explain it a little
sure.
more later.
So,
I know that's
we have a few
about.
Folks who just walked in. Thank you, Leslie. Hey, thanks. Hey, woo! Wendy! Paul teaches animation, and we talked about having an animation station set up, and so he was thinking of running off for a minute and setting up the station, because we have some kids here who might be interested. Hi!
Hi.
Do you guys want to do an animation? Do you want to check it out, or? Yeah! All right, so we're gonna have a brief interlude.
Cool. I'm just gonna turn it on pretty much. It won't be very long at all.
It's meant to be long. Hi everybody. So the house is starting to fill. The people are starting to come in. Since everyone just came in, we've got some art in this room, but also if you go around the corner and to the right, there's more art and there's also a bathroom. I forgot to mention bathroom for people.
There's beverages too, right?
So a friend of mine says this is the first party I've been to in years. Well, you know, put a flower in your hair, Wendy, and kick up your feet. We've got like a few more songs to do. Sydney! All right, I'm gonna go give somebody a hug.
Thanks. Yeah.
This is
so fun. I'm sorry. Like,
it's
okay. I went to Michael's yesterday, and I was like, perfect. Perfect on you and the colors.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, just running around getting all this stuff together.
Looks amazing. Yeah.
Cool. Anybody have any questions for me? Since I'm kind of like in this live virtual spotlight thing happening.
How long have you been singing?
How long have I been singing? Well. I was singing, I guess I started singing probably in grade school, you know, the chorus. But I started my first band when I was 15. And I led that, 15 and a half. I was 15 and a half when I started playing. And I did my first show at CBGB's when I was 16.
Wow.
Yeah. It was fun, a little bit scary, but you know. You know, it's always scary.
Yeah.
How tall am I? I am 5'6" and a half.
Although with Tom Cruise's shoes, you could be like the oldest.
Yeah, when I put on Tom Cruise's shoes, I'm like 6 feet tall. Yeah, my first band was called The Liquid Faction. It was based on a group. There was this. I was really into William S. Burroughs because, you know, I was a goth kid. and like, you know, I had to just, you know, read anything that might be controversial. And there was a group in that book called the Liquefactionists. So we were like, anyone who knows William Burroughs would know who the faction is, so then they would be so cool. But we were way too cool. I remember moshing. Oh yeah, my first gig with the Liquid Faction was at the Clinton Community Center, which is Clinton, New Jersey, and it was like a VFW.
Oh yeah, you gotta play there. That's gotta be your first gig if you're in a rock band in a small town. Like,
oh, Bee Gees.
Yeah. So, The Foo Fighters are putting out a new album. Bee Gees covers.
Jeff, for you to say that I hit every note, that's awesome, especially as a keyboardist, because, you know, you can't fake it.
I was responding.
Somebody
said
it. The many faces.
Is it okay if I put your dog?
Oh, yeah, that's
beautiful.
Of course, we forget those things.
Not the important thing. The music's the important thing. I got some.
Thanks. A bowl is coming out. Money's being put in it. Yeah. It's very exciting.
We've completely, you get busy
doing other things and you forget about that.
All right. Yeah.
So, okay.
BG's, Foo Fighters are making one. Who's the Foo Fighters? For those who don't know, it's Dave Grohl from Nirvana, his rock band. They're huge if you don't know who they are.
It's their alternate band, whatever they're calling themselves. I forget. Yeah, they have an alternate personality band.
It's
the Bee Gees. They do the Bee Gees covers. But I have a friend who... Yeah, all right, never mind. I don't know where you were going with that. You were talking about Foo Fighters.
Yeah, I was. I didn't realize anything.
I put money in this jar.
Oh, cool.
All right. That's good, too.
That's all right.
Yeah.
That one's more elegant, but sure.
That's good. All right. We'll just get on to this one.
Okay.
We love talking.
Put it all in here.
This is from their early era.
Sweet!
Hopefully, the Bee Gees phenomenon. I'm going to stop talking and
just
sing the song. Hope you enjoy this.
In the morning, when the moon is at its rest, you will see me at the time I love the best, watching rainbows play on sunlight, pools of water, ice from cold nights. In the morning, 'tis the morning of my life. In the daytime, I will meet you as before. You will find
folk songs from the Bee Gees, like when I was like 5 years old, and then it took me like 35 years to hear them again, and it was amazing to rediscover those songs, because I'm like, I know these songs, and it's just like, haunting how good they are.
Yeah.
That one was a rare one though. That one wasn't on the radio.
And
those
Bee Gees.
Those Bee
Gees,
yes. Yeah, yeah. They have one called Massachusetts, where I was living before I came here. It's a beautiful song.
Oh my God, Massachusetts.
Heart wrenching.
Now we're gonna go from beautiful to
cathartic.
That sounds good.
Yeah. This is one of my favorite bands. Replacements. But also one of my favorite songwriters, Paul Westerberg. I'm as big of a fan of his solo work as what he did with the Replacements.
Let me make sure the lights on, people can see in there. I'll be right back, folks.
Okay.
You guys are hosting a party and doing the show and providing the art. And
yeah, we're wearing a lot of hats tonight. we're also driving Uber, so we may have to make a run.
Oh, no.
I'm joking. Where's our drummer to give a little crash, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, this guy, you better watch out. People find out you're a drummer, you may not be able to tell.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Holly's band is looking for a drummer.
Oh, by Sophia's.
Yeah, all female.
It's all female, but they say they'll take a male, they're chill.
Yeah.
Do you
play
drums?
Not as good
as him.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Are you talking about this one?
So, I assume
that's going out live.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, so I'll set up this song a little bit more. The Replacements never really had any hits. They were kind of a college radio band. And apparently they were like big into self-sabotage. They just got really wasted for their shows. They really kind of like were, it was an uphill battle against the success that they were being like kind of like offered. They just kept sabotaging. Apparently they were just so nervous they would just get wasted. And that's what they were known for. And they had some death, and it was pretty tragic because like the death did not help the band. It was like they had already broken up, the band they couldn't get a break, and really didn't care either. So that's what this song's about. It's called Treatment Bound.
It's called what?
Treatment Bound.
Yeah, bound for some treatment. 1, 2.
As fast as we can, get a note.
Usually. So you got the replacement story.
Yeah.
What's next?
Yeah, check out Paul Westerberg if you don't know his music.
Oh, I'm losing my religion.
Great songwriter. Oh my god. Your world is a balloon to me. I poke a hole and see what's inside.
Oh.
His songs are tragic, but they're so witty and fun.
Was it really Cottonwood Tsitsi song?
No, I throw that in there. He sings Duluth to Madison. Because he's from
Wisconsin. What did I do with the song?
They're from Minneapolis.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Good music town. Couldn't be different from further than some of my other favorite artists. What are we doing?
All right.
Okay, yes.
We got a few more. If you guys need more light, because we do have like art hanging here. There are some switches if you want to see things.
Okay, it's so quiet in here. You wouldn't know we're having a party. That's a sign of a good. It's a sign of a good. There we go. It's a sign of a good audience. You know, you're all like listening. So,
just quiet.
So,
yeah.
You know, it's fine.
We're not background music in the show. It's kind of nice.
So yeah, this one's from the late '80s. It kind of has a '90s feel, but. Great music video, one of my favorite bands, and probably their most popular song ever done.
Yeah, you'll recognize it quick.
Ready?
We made our own harmonies, though.
Yes, that is true, and so that makes this version a little special. Yeah, very special.
Spot, I lose in my religion.
We used to play all like awesome REM songs, and then like we gotta do something like a little like less obvious. But you know, it's such a great song. The reason I started playing it is I started playing it without learning it like one time, and I was like, all right, I have to learn it, because I was just getting the chords all wrong, and I thought I knew it, and I didn't. So it's a lesson to you out there. Just go learn it for real, and if you don't like it, then move on. Yes. Yeah, Holly wrote all those harmonies, right? So much fun. She's speaking of harmonies, this one.
What? Your drummer?
It's Apple. She's played a couple of
times. Do you need a
overdoing Love Is Blindness?
Yeah.
We're not doing Pete.
Oh, yes, we're doing Pete.
Oh, thanks. So this one's an original by Paul. It's called Beat.
I know this one.
Yep.
Thank you.
that's a Planet Sandwich song. That's a rock band that I front, and that's on our, well, two albums ago now, believe it or not, on Yo Pluto.
so we do that one again. A re-release.
Yeah.
That was a fun album. So we got to celebrate the whole lunar legacy with Planet Sandwich. And so our album being called Yo Pluto, that was pretty cool. Just kind of serendipitous.
Do you need this one?
Yeah, I do. Can I turn it?
Yep.
All right. No.
That's not it.
You can... I had it, but I don't know where it went, so, yeah, you know.
Okay, so this one.
It's tiny.
Yep, this is tiny.
There it is.
This is nice. Another one that doesn't have harmonies. Beautiful song. Not as well known as Losing My Religion, but very popular band from the same era.
Yeah.
So, and it ties into an earlier song because Jack White covers this one as well.
I didn't know that till after I learned this, and
So the Jack White and The Edge from U2 did this movie together called It Might Get Loud. It's about guitar players and their different styles. So those two guys hung out with Jimmy Page for a bunch of days, and they were all just like, that was pretty much the movie.
It was great.
Yeah, it's a great documentary. It really puts things into perspective.
You're totally blushing. As if he was there.
I know, right? I haven't met them, but I would totally blush. All three of them.
Hi, Brad. It's so weird. We've got a lot. Yeah. Okay, anyway.
I know.
Let's do this. Yeah. We got a few,
bouncing
a few
off the
left, and then we're good.
Without mourning.
The Edge wrote that one. Bono sings it. It's on one of their most popular albums called Optoon Baby. With,
Are you sure you want to do that one?
No.
Alright.
It's like the hardest one we have on the list.
Yes.
I'm like,
ah. I haven't played it in like 6 months and I was like,
we can do that one. Are we
Yeah, I think it's just
down the light.
Chances and Papa Jeans or just Papa Jeans?
Yeah, we'll do Chances.
Okay.
That's not on there either, is it?
It's right there.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, it's getting dark in here. All right, so we have two songs left.
Yep.
We're not torturing you guys. You're such a good audience.
This is a great audience. This is what I imagine it would feel like doing this like a songwriter workshop sort of thing where like everyone's having a good time. But everyone, they're really listening, and I don't know. I feel this is what it would be like, a songwriter workshop sort of thing. Hopefully, we're streaming it.
It seems like it's working.
I got it pulled up over here.
Oh, sweet. Yeah.
Okay.
It's
so.
I start with the harmonica on this one, don't I?
I reckon?
Yeah.
Well, so if you're streaming it, you have a recording, so you can take samples out of this too.
Oh, yeah. Freebird! Somebody has to say it.
Of course. Is that Brad?
No. My friend Wendy. We don't have any Boston songs. We'll have to learn that one for you.
Boston. You seen Freebird is by the band
No,
Boston?
No, but I don't know.
Okay, let's... Yeah.
Wendy likes Boston.
Oh, I'd love to do some Boston. Big fan.
Okay. All right.
This is an original... Inspired by John Prine.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh. Yeah.
Rest his soul.
Yep. And, and it's probably my songs aren't generally that funny, but I think it has one of the funniest lines in that I've written.
Yeah.
I tried to write a bridge that was, like, unique, and I felt like I was successful, and it also had a lot of humor. So, Pumpkin, so it's between the daughter... And the father, and the father says, "Pumpkin, you got my blessing with the soul Smith and Wesson." And then the daughter says, "Pa, like a salad with no dressing, I could use a little more." So, salad with no dressing. Apparently, that tickles a few funny bones. We'll see how it does when I sing it.
Salad.
Dressing? What's that? Okay.
Two cases. Let's start this again.
It picks up right out here.
Okay.
This is the top.
Thank you.
thinking you got my blessing from the sword Smith and Wesson. A few times, but you know, it's still relatively new.
Yeah.
It'll be on the Holly Polly CD for sure. We started recording and stuff, so all right, so we're gonna wrap it up with one more.
You got one more
oldie but goodie.
Yeah, this one was written by my favorite monkey.
Ooh.
I bet you can get, can you guess, can you guess who?
Ringo.
Davy.
It was you, not Davy.
It's not eccentric enough. A little obvious for Holly.
He wore a beanie. Okay. I'll give you that hint.
Mike
Nesmith.
God.
I was in love with Mike.
Mike was great.
I was in love with all of them, but Mike was my ultimate favorite.
Aren't you friends with him on Facebook?
I'm friends with Mike Nesmith on Facebook.
Maybe he's watching. Maybe he's watching. Wouldn't that be funny if he's watching?
Oh my God, it's
like
true.
Streaming.
Yeah.
I like these guys.
Right. Mike, if you're out there.
Don't be too critical.
We love you.
We do. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Happiness that's all rolled up in you.
There's a chorus, and you didn't do it, so that's all.
You weren't playing the part that I needed to sing, though.
Sure.
I guess we're gonna keep doing it.
Love is a rose, but you better not pick it.
Oh, you're right. I was singing a verse.
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
I think it's funny because you're like, you're right. I'm like, I don't want to make an issue of
Let's chorus the song.
Totally. No, it's amusing. Right. It's okay. Okay, ready?
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Love is a rose, but you better not pick. You lonely grows when it's on the vine. Handful of thorns and you know you miss, but you lose your love when you say the word mind. Mind. Love is a rose.
We've been reworking the harmonies on this, so like that was a little odd because we just went back to the old way that we did it, and like it's probably not the strongest choice, but that's what you get sometimes, you know.
All right, anyway, thanks everybody.
That's awesome.
Good night.
Thanks everyone.
Bye.